How's everybody doing?
How are you doing?
How are you doing? Oh, it's a beautiful,
beautiful day.
Hey man, if you get that Soros check to clear, you gotta tell me, alright? Mine have been bouncing. Soros writes those rubber checks, you know what I'm saying? Boy oing. I can't get a single one to clear. Thank you!
Thank you
for the resubscribe. You're the best. Ah, the Blue Rose Witch. 10 months! 10 months! Can you believe it? Can you believe what The Rock is cooking? I know you can smell it, but can you believe it? Can you believe what's in the air fryer tonight? Welcome to Hold Space for My Tribe, also known as the communal air fryer. Okay, and you never wash it. We've got a cast iron air fryer here, folks. You do not want to scrub that down with your soaps, okay? That's going to strip the seasoning off. And we don't want that. We're trying to. When you make eggs in our communal air fryer, do not wash it, all right?
Subscribe for more videos.
Don't ever, Travis, don't ever clean your air fryer, I'm telling you. Sizzle me. Lay me down and listen to me sizzle. Is that indigestion or is it the sweet, sweet heat from the communal air fryer? You'll never know. You should deglaze it. Yeah, you know what you can do? You can pour some salt on it and then lick the salt off. That usually does the trick. That's what I do with all of my cookware, all of my crockery. Dump kosher salt on it and lick it off. That's how you clean crockery. Salt and ormus. That's what I do. You get your salt, you get your ormus, you get your tongue, and you go in there and you wash up like a good boy. That's what... Oh, for my birthday, I wanted to go to Shasta. Well, did ya? I'm trapped up here in the north. I can't go. I'm sorry. I don't know when your birthday is, though, either. George Ormus. I'm harvesting my eggs to poach in our communal air fryer. Breakfast will be ready in 500 years. That's going to be an expensive breakfast, and I can't wait. I said they did not go. It was on Sunday. Well, happy birthday to you! And hello, Claydonius. I wish you all the best. The Mystic Theurge, I really do. I hope it was a good birthday.
Don't ever try this.
I hope you've had a good time in the California sunshine. Philosophical, like Play-Doh chips. I'll take it. I'll entertain that. Do not you ever. I'm happy you remember that. Y'all like all that, obscene, I was gonna say lewd, but it really is obscene spam we were getting in the yurt group on Facebook. Some good stuff in there. None of it tasteful. Big ups to Pop-Tart for helping with the moderation of that. I'm glad somebody missed it. It seemed like some of it was up for quite a while. I saw some, saw Standing 69. What else did I see? I saw Good Old Fashioned Anal. I saw a woman being mounted by a dog. That'll get your group stricken. Did you see Dong? Yeah, several. There was Animal. Yeah, I saw it too. And by the way, Pop-Tart, if you do not want this job, then just don't do it. Please don't. Don't expose yourself to things you don't want to see. I don't want you to do that. I'm happy you're helping out, because I don't look at the socials that much either. But yeah. So anyway, yeah, if you want to see some, you know, some pretty offensive shit, go to our Facebook group a week ago. Bless! A big bless to everybody!
To everybody!
I'm going to go ahead and get started here. I know that we're going to have a lot of problems today, okay? So let's suffer now so that we can have fun later. How about all of you be good so that I can be bad? I need you
to be good
so that I can be bad. All right? Do we have a deal? Yeah, reporting it doesn't do anything. I tried that. You just gotta... I don't know. I mean, I don't really care about our Facebook group. We have the Discord, but, holy shit, we're getting raided. I better start my engine. See, I knew it wasn't gonna work, though. Hey, it did! Ha ha! Wow! 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 We got me up close.
Wow! Wow! We got me back here!
Wow! Booty slappers in here with a skull with an ass on it. I'm having fun, and everybody's saying,
"What's up?
Happy birthday! Happy birthday, indeed!" Look at this. Well, hey, welcome. We're just getting started. Welcome to Hold Space for My Tribe. I am Mind Chopo. I'm your new dad. I'm going to be showing you through some of the worst parts of the internet today. And I'm real sorry about it, but you're stuck. You have to stay here. You've signed the contract. I own your assets. And if you'd like to spank me, it does cost 2,000 Chopo bucks. But I'll give you a little preview right now. The paddle comes up, it whacks me. Ooh! And I say whatever you'd like me to say when doing so. When you redeem the spank, please do include your dictation in the chat. So you are stuck in the boneyard. I am your bone daddy. Don't ever Travis.
Don't ever try this.
And we do crack whip.
Don't ever try this.
Okay. And the cult initiation requires one piss chug and one smoke pube. Why the hell doesn't the bot work? I don't know. Listen, I don't know. But I have one thing for you to start the day, all right? We're just going to get in the mood, okay? This is what we're doing.
Today on the menu, this huge wheelbarrow of tomatoes.
Have you ever seen this? A screaming purple orb sent me this video. Have you ever seen any animal eat a tomato? Let alone eat a tomato whole? I haven't.
Today on the menu,
so that's wheelbarrow. So this, you know, we're just getting in the mood. I got to warm you up, all right? You can't. I don't just go for it. I'm not like other guys, okay? I know we got to warm up. I recently found a psychic that I think I can get down with, and so here's a psychic prediction for the day, and I think we can all get down with this psychic.
Hi, Bethany Whitman here. I have a prediction for this weekend, everybody.
You gotta edge the chat, that's true.
Magic. Magical things are going to be happening. So you can have lots of fun. You might even see a ghost, a saint, a spirit.
Wouldn't that be fun? You gotta get your fortune told, and she's like, I don't know.
You might see a ghost.
Magic stuff. I don't know. Anything could happen. You go get a psychic reading. You go get a psychic reading. I'm doing a Miss Cleo over here. Hashtag cancel me. Hashtag blow my spot. This is what a manic pixie dream girl looks like in your 70s. If you do see a ghost, you better call Amy Beloved. Yeah, you get your fortune read, you know, you pay the 75 bucks, and they're like, anything could happen. I mean, think of the possibilities. It could be...
anything could happen. You can find me pot of gold.
That's, yeah, I love it. I like this whole vibe.
A witch.
A witch.
Angels. So yes, let's enjoy this celebration. Really realize that this world and the next world are this side and the other side.
Yeah.
There's a very thin veil. Let's just drop that veil.
And let's drop that veil, honey.
This Halloween, on your spiritual journey.
And then you're like, oh, right, Halloween's coming up. That's why the psychic thinks I'm going to be seeing all kinds of boogans. We got another reading from our new favorite psychic, though. Let's check it out. Let's jump in.
Hi, Bethany Whitman here. Just wanted to come on today.
Hey, you can keep your veil on. It's all right. Listen, I tell you what to do, and you do have to do what I say to do, but feel free to disregard it as well. Remember, this is a functioning cult. So contradictions and cognitive dissonance are central to the mental state you should be in at all times while under my control. So please, just remember, do what I say, but of course you're free to leave at any time. But if you do, of course, your friends and family will never speak to you ever again, because you have disconnected from them and you have alienated yourself in such a way that you can never come back from it. So, but feel free to leave, of course.
To encourage someone to let go of your fears. I realize that everything's gonna be okay.
How many points for me to spank you? That's free, but you gotta come to my yurt after lights out.
And the more of us that can show love and kindness to one another and believe that everything's gonna be okay, and it
Bless.
Will be. Just trust
Bless Tobo.
And believe. God loves us one and all. And with the love in our heart, as we share it with each other, everything's going to be okay, and it will be. Have a great day.
Listen, this is the kind of psychic I want to see! I want to cough like that guy. Bless us all, everyone. And here's my new favorite song.
About who follows you? Hands go down, clowns go down too. Follow you, I'd save my pride and cough.
Did you hear that? Hands go down and clowns go down too. We're talking about hands and clowns both going down. Okay, so think about this. Hi, it's me. I'm tiny, tiny little Tobo. And, thank you to the Surreal Chemist. Everybody give it up for the Surreal Chemist for subscribing on a seventh month streak. I don't even know. We should have a Hold Space for My Tribe After Dark Patreon stream where we watch tons of foot porn and spank Tobo whenever he says a swear. I'm up for it. I should have announced at the top of the show, we will not be doing a patron stream today. I'm just going to roll over.
Don't ever try this.
Welcome back, Montifica.
Don't ever try this.
We're just going to go for 2 hours today. Powerful Unistream. We're playing swords. We're crossing the streams. We're touching tips. We did watch Will Blunderfield cumb that one time in the patron stream. Yeah, I mean, listen, if we want to do like a kinky hangout, you know, I'm all for it. I'm not even real. So whatever you want to do with my body, that's up to you.
Hands up, who follows you? Hands go down, clowns go down too. Save my pride and call a ride, cause there ain't no round two. I don't flip a credit to debit, you better regret it. You're headed towards ranching. I get it, you're rented a dentist, vintage spindle with window tinting bubbles. Trouble only runs on leaded. Now you regret it. Bubba's rubbing a limousine, using criminal Vaseline. Now he's popping up on the scene, Phil popping up scene. He's drunk but he's mean, I mean he's off and not clean. You're a good court jester, not a good night Irene. You're a good court jester, not a good night Irene. Clowns go down too. Ain't no round two.
What is criminal Vaseline? Can we call this guy? Let me check. Is his Is his number listed somewhere? I would fucking love it. I mean, he doesn't talk like that, you know. But he, well, maybe he does. Maybe he does. Oh wow! It looks like on his. I'll let you in. It looks like holy shit. Whoa. This is his website. Have we looked at his website before? This is something. Holy shit. This is a black vulture made from black duct tape. I have no idea. I'll refine it and make it more realistic in the weeks to come. On his channel, there's like from 14 years ago, it looks like there's some sketch comedy. Today's quote, I say, clown suits. From Emil Sitka. Okay. Lots of shows on the iTunes podcast area. Okay. About Hardy. This is Hardy White. I was born to a mother and father, but not anymore, who ushered me into this world like into a movie. Like a movie usher. But not my father so much. I learned all the great books of Europe and dreamed of reading them someday. I grew up and heard a radio. That's when I was hooked and taken to the island of Lost Boys. When I returned, I sought out radio again with the simple goal of helping people in complicated engineering projects. Holy shit, this is just... Welcome to the home of Hardy White. I'm Hardy White. I call myself the thinnest fat man, but that's not half of what others call me. I'm on WFMU in New Jersey. And even though the show is called Miracle Nutrition without the hour, it's still an hour. I feel strongly about tea making. Holy shit. I'm going to have to get more into this. Also, I hosted a cable access show and am helpful to others in small ways. Wow. All right. Well, that's, I think, possibly for another day. Maybe I'll leave that one up to Little Thursday Boy, but because I sort of have a... I have a loose schedule for us today. We're gonna move on. But first, you know, one of the most beautiful things I've ever seen.
Let's see what's on.
This is Peter Kane, of course. Peter Kane and his best friend. Wow. Yeah, storyline for season 5. I'm aiming for a September launch. Wow. Peter Kane on TikTok, huh? This is the kind of content you can expect. And listen, this video is as long as the Simpsons theme song and nothing else happens. Nothing else happens. Well, so let's get into what I would like to discuss today.
Due to a dog
right after this message.
Goofing piss for 3 years in my hole, and today I have wrinkles in the opening again. Stay educated, sheep.
Yeah, so let's get into what I want to talk about today, which is radionics. And please put in the chat. Please put in the chat your favorite, icks, your favorite subject ending in ICS. You know, are you a fan of Reaganomics? Are you a fan of Teledildonics? Are you a fan of Hooked on Phonics? I would like to know, who is Ray Dionic? More like Dildonics. Yep, keep them coming, keep them coming. I would like more, no pun intended. Amoebix. What about Weetabix for my UK friends? Psychedelics, yeah, okay. Sonic. Uh-huh, pretty good. So, let's get into radionics here a bit. We've sort of covered it before. A lot of it is these machines that have a lot of dials and adjustments to be made, but they don't really do anything. They kind of look like guitar effects pedals. Hello, welcome, Rosie.
Welcome, Rosie. Welcome, Rosie.
We did watch Radionics with P.A. Coetting. We did. I'll take that as Chronics. Your favorite is Chronics. So let's get a little bit more into Radionics, because we've touched it before, but I really want to get the whole thing in our mouth today. So let's
technology. That's what Radionics is. A lost technology. This healing machine I made in 1973 or 74. It's got prayer batteries on it.
Prayer batteries, okay.
Coil in the middle, which is isolated.
Acapella group pentatonics, but beautiful.
It's not actually floating there. There's a piece of perspex holding that in place, insulating it. And then there's these wires and...
So that's kind of an early look. Is radionics similar to where you stick a card into the slot and supposedly can summon demons with the machine?
Yes! Yes!
Yeah! It's all that shit, and we're really going to get into it today. Can it pick up Robin Williams' ghost? Possibly. So yeah, as Rosie has sort of pointed us towards here, there's these machines. A lot of the times you put like a sigil on a card on one part of it, and then you put a photo of someone else, of someone on another part of it, and you kind of, then you do your magics. Use this machine for your magics. Let's look at a sort of an occulty one here. Let's check it out.
Anyways, I'm making some progress on my new...
Also, fucking love it when anything begins with anyways. As if we were discussing something else...
Moments before.
As if I didn't just click play on the video at the beginning of the video. Huh? You tell me anyways... You make me feel like I missed something. Is this the middle of the video? Huh? Is that what's going on? You start your video with anyways.
Anyways, I'm making some progress on my new radionics.
Also, this is Isaac Brock of Modest Mouse and his radionics machine that he himself created.
Next box. This is the NecroBoxCon. And this is the first time I'm doing this.
Can we talk to Biggie? This comes up. This comes up later. Please. Have you already watched this stream? Because there is a reference to Biggie Smalls later. I don't know how you did that. I do not know.
I'm actually using an organite piece for the input. I haven't got the sync plate put on.
Yes. So, J.S. Garrett. I chose not to show any of his videos, but he's real big into the radionics. There's a video of him... wishing a man death using a radionics machine, and he uses some blood and some coffin dust. And if you ask nicely, we can get into it. But I just try to steer clear of the whole become a living boner stuff because I feel like it's a little bit tainted, okay?
Or the output, aka the output. But that's a really interesting concept that I just came up with right there. So I'm going to be using this box for ritual purposes. So I put a compass on there.
Should I not talk so much smack about boners? I mean, they are, you know, they're important. I didn't mean to be derogatory towards anyone's erection. I mean, I think if you can still achieve one, you're doing something right. Whereas I have done many, many, many things wrong. And so mine is long gone.
That way, you know, say I want to cast a circle, you know, say... See, like, I'm facing the east right now, so when I'm calling the corners, I can go over here, and then when I need to face the south, bam, got the south.
Bam, look at that.
Go to the west. Got the west. And when I go to the north...
Look at that.
I got the north.
So, radionics can allow you... To determine which direction you are facing with your radionics machine, so long as you attach a compass upon the surface of it as well. And speaking of well, you would like to listen to Modest Mouse, where the man goes well in most of the music, which I'm a fan of. Let's explore some other devices related to radionics here. I'd like to get into some pyramid power products. Here we go.
Welcome everyone, Dr. Thor here. Get ready for Gnosis. Well, here's some more exciting products. And of course,
yeah,
Radionic Tech has everything, all the best stuff that I've researched for many years. And one of the fascinating products out there that
Dr. Thor's Gnosis
likes, and I'm always looking for special pyramids of one type or another. And
that doesn't mean anything.
Here is a selection that we're offering right now. Now, this wood device is really kind of cool. And you can charge, and I'm not sure if we're going to have these in stock or offer them or not, but
then why I'm
showing them here.
Okay.
It has one of these actual...
Waste my fucking time then, I guess.
...pyramids that are this kind of shape. Let's get this down. Now, the Ethiopians and certain cultures started building these after the...
All right. Do we think we have a read on Dr. Thor yet? Hit me with your harshest judgments in the chat, or your sweetest praise for this person. What's your initial idea? Where do you think this is going? What kind of stuff do you think Dr. Thor is into? And I do have answers for you. Take a minute, think about it. Think about the kind of person who says, "Get ready for Gnosis." Okay, he gets his history facts from night god types. Yeah, little bit of that.
After the Egyptian Empire kind of ended. And it's interesting.
It smells like Old Spice.
And produced the same types of energies.
Butt stuff.
Traditionally shaped pyramids like this.
I understand the butt stuff comment based purely on the structures we're looking at. The implements, the devices, the toys, if you will. And I will.
So this kind of a structure works just as well. And this is covered in a very fascinating book. Here's the book, Pyramid Energy Handbook by Serge King.
So now I've always said this, and you've always ignored me, and I've never let it go. You learn the most about someone by looking at their fingernails. So let's take a look at Dr. Thor's thumbnail down here. It's looking maybe a little bit longer than ideal. There seems to be a pretty solid line of dirt along the top of the nail bed there. He sounds like the guy that sells pocket knives on late night infomercials. Absolutely. Couldn't agree more. Look at those liver spots. So he doesn't believe in sunscreen. Probably a flat earther. Not getting enough nutrition. Has a toe thumb. Sure. I'm sensing a lot of it. Also, I know it's hard for you to see here in the full screen, but we have sort of an idealized illustration of some fingernails here that you can compare the fingernail here. I wouldn't say that they're unkempt, but there certainly is a fair bit of dirt along the top of the nail bed. TikTok thankfully has debunkers for this nonsense now. Yeah, for sure. Hey, Popcorn Braden, welcome to my stream! Spank me, why don't you? Spank me sometime, I like it. Okay, I have the same theory about people's eyebrows. You can tell a lot. Well, the eyebrows are the top of the window to the soul. The blinds of the soul sort. Well, that's more the eyelid. Oh, no, the butt stuff, it good. Yeah, oh, no, I mean, butt stuff is good. Okay, well, so let's go to this person's website. I did locate Dr. Thor's website here. Radionictech.com. We've got a little welcome video here. Let's watch it.
Hi, we offer various manifestation tools. Do you want more money? More energy, perfect relationships.
Valence
IGOS
curtain, thank you.
Success Tech offers cutting edge.
The eyebrows are the fingernails of the forehead. Yeah, that's what I get. So here we have something that was clearly purchased on Fiverr.
Manifesting solutions for your every need. Supercharge the laws of attraction to make your wildest dreams a reality.
Pretty good stuff. Radionics is a science and a spiritual path, so a lot of things for sale here, a lot of things. We've got an Angelonics machine. How much do you think that costs? Is there a price here? No, a lot of text. Gold-plated, okay, so that's $424.95, I'm guessing if you get the deluxe kit cosmic code with rod laser, which I read as red lobster, wrist laser, and unique charging box. So you kind of get the idea here, right? We're selling things. We're selling, what are we interested in? Let's check out perhaps something for family, children, and pets. That's coming soon, and but we've got this image to enjoy in its stead, of course. What's a power cup? Oh, look at this. You can buy a money cup. This is a $50 mug, my friends. Charge your favorite drink with money drawing energy. When you drink from it, the energies of abundance flow directly into your cells and radiate from your entire body. So isn't that nice? And now if we scroll down even further, we've got something that says password protected pages below. Use contact form to obtain an access code. And these are things like psi warfare and mind control dash sexuality. And I know what you're thinking, Chopo, Mr. Tobo, why do you always tease me? Why do you always spank me ever so lightly, but you never actually give what was promised, you know? Well, let me tell you, today I did use the contact form and I did obtain the password to view the weird sex stuff on Dr. Thor's website. So if we click on mind control dash sexuality, this password, this area is password protected. Well, the password is Pop Dragon, as I did receive in an email earlier today. So we can indeed access the sexual sorcery course. Now, I am going to wait here as you shower me with praise, the praise that I deserve for doing my due diligence and preparing for this show earlier this morning. I hope the mind control of sexuality is actually about like trying to wizard yourself into being polyamorous. Thank you, Dabby, is the appropriate thing to write into the chat.
Don't ever try this. Don't ever try this. Don't ever try this.
Yeah. Hey! Thanks for the 9 months, you So everybody write thank you, Dabby, into the chat. Thank you, Mindtobo. You are the greatest, and we do not deserve your ascended greatness. Yep. True. Do not you ever thank you, Dabby Tobo. What are your hobbies? Yeah, well, I have a live stream where people say things to me like, thank you, Dabby Tobo. and I will have your daughter home by 11. Spank you, Patty. That works too. All right, yeah, let's get into it. Let's try to wizard ourselves into polyamory. So here we've got a picture of this book, Sexual Sorcery, Dark and Powerful Sex Magic, Grandmaster Dr. Thor Templar. 30 powerful sexual sorcery sigils. Try saying that 30 times fast, because it starts with 30. Enhance all your sex magic practices, even without a partner and without doing rituals. So just, you might as well not even read the book, because it doesn't fucking do anything. Sexual sorcery audio included. And of course, we have a demo, which I already have open for us here. Let's watch this sensual sorcery book demo from July 20th, 2020, with a grand total of 74 views and 2 likes, okay? So, here we go.
IGOS Success Tech is proud to present Mysterious Books of Masters.
Look at that. Let's read that.
Energize.
Let's read that. The Procedure for Sexual Congress. Yeah, man, I bought this book about how to fuck, and it says stuff like the procedure for sexual congress during day 7 and 8. Yeah, you remember that fucking 90-day program we all got told about in health class in 6th grade? Yeah, what are you supposed to do on day 7 again? I can't remember. Mom, Dad, do you really have to have sex for 8 days to make a baby? So, during day 7 and 8, the following procedure should be used. It may also be explored during everyday sexual practice. Please note the space between every and day, not meaning every day, as in ordinary sexual practice, but meaning daily sexual practice. So, number one, undertake deep relaxation. I thought you had to pee in a girl's mouth. Number two, both visualize yourselves as incarnations, your chosen god forms, Therion and Babylon, Shiva and Shakti, etc., of course. So I think I'll be going with the Hamburglar, and perhaps my partner can be Grimace. Vibrate energy through the chakras. Concentrate on base chakra. I do like a little concentration on the base. Number four, vibrate the hum mantra. That's H-U-M-N. Number five, increase the pitch as foreplay begins. Now, this is where a lot of people go wrong. Herbal Crone, you're in the right place. Welcome. Well, everybody, welcome our new friend. That's the ass. That's what the pyramids are for. Now, people get this wrong. You know, I mean, some people are skipping foreplay entirely, which is a big mistake. Well, of course, nobody knows what Grimace is. Grimace is non-binary, and that's why I selected Grimace, because I want you all to be embodied by the Grimace that I make love to for 7 to 8 days. So the thing about foreplay is that you have to increase the frequency the pitch, sorry, not the frequency, the pitch of your hum mantra. So yes, as we have played the haum, so you know, your beloved, you know, is undressing and you're haum, haum. This is the perfect visual for it, haum. But as things start to get steamy, you're doing your foreplay, it should be a little bit more like haum, haum, haum. Or maybe it sounds more like a hamana. So, you know, you're getting undressed, hamana, 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 hamana. And then, you know, you start to use your metacarpals a bit, and it's hamana, 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 hamana. You know, thing, and this is where a lot of people go wrong. People just go wrong here. Thank you.
Energize your consciousness to achieve anything.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Analogs. I saw the word analogs there. Oh, wow. What could this be? Let it become blacker than all blackness. And in this meditation, thou shalt be utterly without fear. For that the blackness will appear unto thee is a thing dreadful beyond all comprehension. So that's some stuff I haven't gotten into yet, but, you know, with time.
Exclusive sacred geometry.
It is a picture book.
Allows you to fill your hand body with,
you know,
limited manifestation.
There's that. We got that. Now, okay. You know, what's going on? This is like a scrambled porn book in the, I mean, up here, but then we've got, does anybody know who this is with this filter? This book fucks. And the music!
Draw and command spirits to do your bidding.
Notice energy orb emerging from the IGOS books. It says across the bottom of the screen, you can't see this. Once again, I did send an email for us to see this, okay? This isn't my usual link harvest. I did send an email. The sex lasts 40 days because you have to cross the abyss in order to complete. Yeah. That's sexual Cedric the Entertainer.
Add huge amounts of spirit drawing power to any of your rituals.
This is pretty cool. We've got a statue of the Predator there. Everybody loves the Predator. Is that a goblet of cum? I couldn't tell you. Energy orb begins its descent towards the Triforce system before departing. I love energy orb stuff because it's just people admitting that their homes are dusty.
Broadcast the energy of your favorite audio amulet right to your atmosphere.
Okay. So we've got, I mean, this looks pretty fucking lewd to me. I don't know. This looks like images from a colonoscopy mixed with some Hubble telescope stuff. It's labeled sexual sorcery. And so this is a DVD player that I believe has been converted into a radionics device. As you can see here, it says placed photo here. And now everybody's smoking their own pubes, which I'm very, very happy about. Everybody's smiling. She's smile. So apparently you can also use DVDs in radionics magic. Place the photo there.
Just insert.
You got me.
voice, push play, and you're ready to go. Fill your aura with power on the go.
With your pumpkin CD player. Place the photo. There we go. Look at that. Yeah.
Charge your favorite drinks, crystals, and more just by placing them on top of the front cover.
That's all it takes. Pretty cool stuff.
Exponentially increase the power of your radionic genes.
Exponentially. Oh, I didn't see your video link. Sorry, Britta. So it's good stuff, and there's more. I have good news for you. If you could send me that link on the Discord, Britta, that'd be great. If you're on that, or if somebody else could copy that or something. Fill every hole of aura now and try not to come. Tap to play. Why are people always trying not to come? I don't get it. Sexual sorcery cell is another thing we've got here. A mind control course. Now, let's get into it, of course, but I'm warning you, I have not watched this. So if this gets weird, just know I don't want it to. Okay? This piss will make you come in 30 seconds. I really need you to dig. All right, let's go.
IGOS Success Tech is proud to present Mysterious Books of Masters.
Here we go. Well, maybe let's read about it just to ease my worries a little bit. So this mind control, sexual psychic shit, a psychic commanding system to program yourself and others. So perhaps we weren't far off with trying to wizard ourselves into polyamory. This completely rewritten book that includes a much more effective system than the 30-year-old original system. Powerful sigils are supplied throughout the book that will empower you simply by viewing them daily. This is a mysterious book of masters which activates powerful psychic centers and your higher self by just owning the course and viewing the sigils. You don't have to read the book. You don't have to read it. Hey, thank you for subscribing! 6 seasons and a movie. Hell yeah, baby. That's what we're doing. When I came in here and saw you, my first thought was, man, Max Headroom really let himself go. I get that a lot, and it's a compliment. I like Max Headroom. This method comes from the secret...
You. My question to you is, who the fuck are you to question me? Huh? Who the fuck are you? I bet you're fucking nobody, and you just got fucking programmed by all the shit that fucking ATN is talking about.
Okay, I respect when someone plays that drop, I respect it, I pause. This method comes from the secret magical guilds and is the only course of its kind available to the public, to the pubic, if you will. This book is designed to be used by both sexes, all right, and all sexual orientations, okay? It not only details psychic commanding of others, yikes, but it details how to reprogram yourself to achieve all your desires. Do not let the title fool you, as it is more than sexual psychic domination. The system can be used in all areas of your life. It is a powerful manifestation system. All right. I feel like it's only going to be, like, pretty problematic, not totally heinous. So, Guild Wars 1 character.
Energize your consciousness to achieve anything you desire. I'm a very good bad
boy. That's right, baby. Oh, look at that.
Our exclusive sacred geometry technology allows you to fill your mind and body with unlimited manifestation.
Right, so these are the sigils. That one's pretty cool.
Broadcast the energy of your favorite audio amulet right through your atmosphere.
Just podcast your favorite energy.
Just insert the audio amulet of your choice, push play, and you're ready to go.
I love this bullshit that you just have a DVD player not even hooked up to anything, and you put some magic stuff in it and just let it spin. Pretty cool. Cool idea.
Your aura is power on the go.
On the go. I'm so busy. Look at that.
charge your favorite drinks, crystals, and more just by placing them on top of the front cover.
Very similar to the other one. Let's see if we can maybe read some of this. Maybe... The influence of command programming on another person is immediate. In other words, when you generate commands from the inner magical being, the target will feel the effects immediately. Okay, yeah, in other words. Scientific studies using very sensitive electromyography, galvanometers, thank you for giving me the time to figure out how to say that word. Galvanometer. And many other sensitive radionic type devices have been proven that once the command program is sent to a person by an experienced practitioner, the results are instantaneous. This means that the commands are received by the target immediately, but it does not mean that the target will act like a robot to your commands. This would be wonderful, but it is not part of the real magical reality. As your command programming starts to take effect on the target, there may be all kinds of blockages created by the target at first. So it doesn't work, but that's not the author's fault. It's that kind of... It's an audio amulet. Okay. All right. Okay. Let's take a look at someone whose life has been influenced by radionics, okay? This person used radionics to manifest the life that they wanted, and we're about to get a window into that life.
Hey, so in regards to manifesting SP, which is a specific person, it could also be a job, it could even be an animal. This is Ollie. I guess I actually manifested him because I wanted a really sweet vision. Usually these guys, the males, are kind of obnoxious and like to bite you and wing slap you. And he's just very, very sweet. So manifesting, you can just write down your desire or even think it. Think it very, very lightly, and then you forget about it and it happens. Or you think about it consistently and it happens. There's really no specific way for manifesting. What works for one person may not work for another person. Like this little guy, I remember several years ago, I just thought it would be nice to have a really sweet pigeon.
Yeah, I used a fucking bullshit machine to manifest a bird that yells every 2 seconds. It's great. It's super loud, and it doesn't ever stop. So what works for me might not work for you. I don't know.
That's would like to be pet and would like to hang out with me. I mean, he's semi-cuddly, so I can't say I got everything I wanted. But he's really, really sweet. So it's nice. So, yeah. Whatever it is you want, you know, it's really up to you whether you want to think about it all the time, or imagine acting as if, fake it till you make it, live in the end until you have it. I'm in the jungle right now. That's having a lot of noisy birds. That's why it's loud. Anyway, yeah, so whatever works for you, try something at least 30 days, and if it doesn't work, move on, try another way. Even being obsessed with something isn't necessarily...
You can try 12 things per year.
How some of the inventions that have been made today and the breakthroughs, whether it's science or technology. I mean, you had people that were probably so obsessed with trying to bring their idea to fruition that they worked on it constantly every day. And maybe it didn't work. And then
you hear that one?
They just kind of kept track of their progress.
Yeah.
Just think about what you want. No. The most important part is to know exactly what you want. And
for real.
Be specific if you can.
You know, you can use technology or you can use bread. And I mean, bread is just foam, as we have learned. There's some other stuff I want to show you. I'm leading up to a sort of a climax here, as I generally do. But we gotta work up for that. It's not fun if it's over so quickly. Let's look at some more radionic machines. I really want us to understand. I want us to be able to visualize these.
In this video, I'll show you how to get the MR200Q, two-channel quantum radionic manifestation machine, up and going in just minutes. These instructions also apply to the MR400Q, the four-channel machine. The only difference being is that there is an extra cable to plug into the device. Plug the enclosed thumb drive into your PC's USB port.
Here we go.
Go to the directory and double-click where it says Modular Radionics Setup.
You know me.
Follow the simple installation instructions.
I love the intersection between technology and bullshit. This is for me. This is for me. Show me the entire installation process, baby. What version of Windows you run in here?
Once the program is installed, double-click on the Modular Radionics icon, and this will open up the interface.
Look at that.
Now, you can plug in your device. The software will detect it by flashing a
green light on the top left-hand corner. Look at this fucking left-hand program.
It will also recognize whether it's a two or four-channel device.
This thing's crawling with malware.
We have a two-
crawling with spywares. Look at this shit. Intent detector, entropy on or off. This is beautiful. Channel one is now selected. It's a synth. It's a synth for your wishes. It's a MIDI controller for outcome. Now look at this. To select the target, like putting the photo on the CD player, we're going to select mark. Double click on it. We're going to select a color for this intent. Click on the color box and they'll bring up the color selector. What color is your intent? Can you use this to manifest the loud pigeon to shut the fuck up? You would have thought so. What color is your intent, baby? David Schwimmer and Prince. Trend. We double click the Ellen image. Ellen DeGeneres. Oh, what do you want me to say? Well, you spank me. We use cards. On the left side, you have a list of all the available card categories. Click on the category that's most related to your intent. In this case, romance. Mary, what do you want me to say while I get spanked? Cool, so we select the rose. You can add an audio track, so that's cool. Nice. Yeah, you can place your own MP3 files in this directory. Amber is the color of my energy. Hey! Grab my dick and double click. All right, I can make that happen for you. Let's take a ride on my sweet leather paddle. Oh,
grab my dick and double click.
All right. It's quicker to beat off on a sigil, isn't it? More environmentally friendly, too. You don't have to turn on a computer. Just beautiful stuff. Type in your intent for Mark with two A's to start dating Ellen. And they're not correcting that spelling mistake. So that's pretty cool. That's pretty cool stuff. Quantum intent detector. If you're going to wish for either a positive intent or a negative intent, that's something you want to avoid. Okay, the dial will be green for a positive intent. Holy shit. They can feel my negative intent. Oh no. Your modular radionics device is now producing a stream of entropy. That is what is being charted. The entropy is affected by your intent either in the positive or negative direction. Okay. Thank you, Jimmy. Always got my back. Look at this shit. Hey! Hold space for my tribe. Thanks for following. I'm following myself. I'm auto-following right now. and we have cheered ourselves as well. Truly jerking off in front of you in this moment. You need to be wishing your intent, in this case, for Mark to date Ellen. Okay, we subscribe to ourselves as well, so... You probably shouldn't download this, but I want you to. Just to be clear. Just to be clear, don't do this, but I do, but I want, I would like you to. Wow. What a world. Entropy images. Look at that. Now let it rip. An intent is 500 frequencies and it takes about 2 hours. Hold the fucking phone. An intent, it takes about 2 hours to send the frequencies to the device. It says, love this. I'm in the building and I'm following myself. I'm a very good bad boy. Say it again. So that's some fun bullcrap there. We had something sent in by a viewer, didn't we? Let's maybe take a moment for that. Call of the Shaman, Jaw Harp Trance. How could we go wrong with that? We can't. Here we go. Thank you, Britta, for this, just in advance. I feel good. I feel good about where this is going. 2 hours is how long it takes them to export the clone of your hard drive to their systems. Yeah. Fucking spank away, baby. You got all those points. Don't let them just sit there. Here we go. Here's a bird lady for you, huh? Pretty good. Look at this. The confidence it would take. Beautiful stuff. I need to have my noise-making game. Hole has opened. Are you all voting yes on Tobo? Thank you. The jaw harp is just a cartoon sound. Wow. The fringe. Pretty good. She's harping and yarping. She's whooping and hollering. Oh, here we go. Holy shit. There's some dolphin in there for sure. Much like a lot of tuna I have eaten. I'm sure there's some dolphin in this.
Hey,
This is quite impressive. Fuck to this, yeah. Hey, later, Eldridge. Thanks for stopping by. Big fan of the headband. She could use a headlamp. This could be Sandstorm. And again. Wow. It's cool stuff. I vote have a good one to Eldridge. Wow. That breath. Not bad. Well,
my wife's like, what'd you do?
Well, that's something. That's a
nice one, Britta.
I feel pretty good about that. Oh, Nosemaster. Sure thing. Sure thing. We've got the Nosemaster, of course. Let me bring it up. I should have the Nosemaster, you know, a little more on hand, but it just takes me a sec. Here we go. The Nosemaster. Here we go. You wanted Nosemaster, and it shall be provided to thee. The audio of this gets funnier to me every time. Fuck! Look at that! Everybody's having such a good time. That's really what gets me. All right, it has been decided. To Eldritch Gravy, we do say, have a good one. This is a man who can write a book on day 9 foreplay. Yeah, it's true. Wow, Nosemaster, thank you for redeeming the
Nosemaster.
Alright, let's get into the meat and potatoes of my fucking bullshit right now. Well, okay, one thing before that. Let's check out this Pyramid Power video, okay? Look at, fucking look at this. Andronian. Okay, do you follow? Do we recognize him or do we not? Is that our boy? Is that my little friend? For the last 3 years, I have spent day and night and every penny on trying to back engineer a device that is telepathic by nature. Do we recognize them? Looks like my friends, the citizen, the females. The architects of this device are ex-territorial by nature and will allow such a device to be built and working when the time is right. Look at him. There he is. It's our boy. The ones who have been in communication with me, helping me with the instructions to build it, are known as the Arcturians. The Arcturian energy is... Okay, I missed it. The females allow the connection to all universal information of any time. Pretty cool. However, the design itself is universal. I will now explain how the device came to me and why these devices are so important for the future aid of the human race. Holy shit. 3 years ago in August 2007, I was driving my car through the forest. I had been thinking about the legends of the great crystal technology that had existed in Atlantis time. I was wondering how to unlock the potential of the quartz crystal, how to truly communicate across all space and time beyond the light speed barrier. Then suddenly a concept came to me. The voice, like emotion, said to me, "If you are serious about your idea, know that there is a group of us, and groups of us in the universe that can telepathically communicate with you through a symbol. The symbol is an interlocked equation that operates outside of time." Anyways, there's some pretty cool stuff. I like the end. I like the ending is pretty good. Yeah, I'm looking for all the help and support I can get. So this should make a lot of sense to you if you've viewed the entire video. I strongly feel that this device is meant to be completed by a contribution of a multiple group of individuals working together, as also it is not meant for me to do it on my own. That is the way it is intended to be, for it is a sacred device and requires open-hearted people to build it. Yes, indeed. And there it is. So, if you want to be involved, get in touch with Shane Cox. Shane Cox is your man for this. Alright, now time for the meat and potatoes. I'm going to introduce you to a friend. This is the Wish Doctor. I would like to introduce you to. Let me get to where I want to be here. Yeah, so this is the Wish Doctor. Clowns go down too, alright? The Wish Doctor, this is the Wish Doctor's TikTok, featuring such videos such as this. Okay. And it says, he got his moves thanks to the wishing machine. Who knew he had moves? TheWishDoctor.com. There's videos like that. There's videos like this.
Yeah, I wrote that book, Get What You Want. It may seem or feel like magic, but really not. This book is a...
Decry in the chat. All the best to you.
A big blast
to Decry in the chat.
Good companion to this machine, which is...
So please do note just quickly that the Wish Doctor's name is Kelsey Graham, not Kelsey Grammer, okay? We will not be making that mistake again.
Really not. This book is a good companion to this machine, which is... And I don't have the testicle.
I don't have the testicle.
This is what I call the Trinity Machine.
Neither do I.
Tepaphone part that has a purple plate for the stick plate, not just a regular white little whatever, purple plate. Tesla energy plate is what it's called. A Oregon pyramid. And then, of course, this activates as the, you got it, the vampire machine. And this comes with a manual.
Now, this might seem like a lot of nonsense to you, okay? It really might. And I don't blame you. This is the Wish Doctor, Kelsey Graham. Obviously, that's for the dick. Now, what if I told you that I called this man earlier today to confirm his schedule and when he would be free so that I may call him? Because this is the situation. Forget what if I told you that. I am telling you that. So... I have an appointment to call this man just after 7 o'clock Pacific time, and we will be doing so on the stream, of course, and this is why we're not doing a separation for the patron stream. So let's really absorb this device. Let's really absorb the situation. Let's get the vibe. We need to know what the device looks like, what it does. And so if you'll join me for the next 20 minutes or so, it's maybe a little bit more, let's really dig in and let's really get Kelsey Graham hissed. Let's really absorb the Wish Doctor so that when we speak to him, we can get the most out of it. We can really optimize our experience. Here's another Wish Doctor TikTok video. Look at this.
So what is your wish? Do you have a wish? I am the Wish Doctor. We can make your wishes come true.
Okay.
So what?
It's a little odd. I did access more Wish Doctor videos here.
Here is the latest wishing machine going out today. It is finished.
There will be a quiz.
This.
Let me get this in higher qual for you. We like more qual.
This is a step or two up from the basic wishing machine. It's not.
It's got the nipple clamps there.
Does not have a tepiphone, and it doesn't have the vampire. It is a wishing machine that is beefed up to the max. It has the Tesla coil. It has the
testicle
pyramid. It has the purple plate, which all has their significance in the use of a wishing machine. And the components inside this box are beefed up as well. So this is the Wish Doctor, Dr. Graham, www.thewishdr.com. Your wishes and intentions can come true. And I want to tell you, along with this, I have published a book. I'm working on a couple of more books.
Yeah.
And I encourage you to also get a copy of my book, Get What You Want. Right there, everybody wants money.
The subtitle of the book is, It May Seem Like Magic, But It Really Isn't. But yet he's selling the wish machine. He has something else called like a vampire machine. We'll get into that.
Money, right? Little book. It really, if you want to enhance the results of this, get this book to go with it. You can find it on Amazon.com, or you can get a hold of me, and I will send it to you as well. In fact, I'll send you an autographed copy if you get it directly from me.
Pretty cool.
You can message me wherever you're seeing this video, or you can call me at 888-501-6689. And when you call, you say, I want to get what I want. I want the book.
I want to get what I want. I want the book. Okay. So, of course, you know my rule on this, okay? I only like to call people who invite it. They're all vampires. This guy makes a vampire machine. So here's our invitation. I want to get what I want. I want the book, all right?
Get what you want. Dr. Graham here and the wishing machine can certainly help you. I caught the law of attraction on steroids, and this one is really beefed up on steroids. www.thewishdr.com, 888-501-6689. Get your wishes to come true today.
Get your wishes to come true today. And he is going to make my wishes come true today. Let's see what he looks like. Let's get into it. Oh boy. Oh boy.
I haven't done an update video.
Pretty cool video.
What I've got going on here, the exciting things.
Hey! Thank you for the 900 cheer.
A lot of people.
By the wish machine. We'll get to that.
The wishing machine. This is the basic model. And then some have had some good success with it. Some have had some great success.
So these are the two options. You either have good success or great success with the wishing machine.
If you've been to the website, you've probably read some of the reviews people have left in regards to the usage of this. And this is the least expensive model of the wishing machine I use.
Yeah.
I have three other items that can be used independently or in conjunction
right.
with the wishing machine, and that's what I want to talk about today. The Psionics helmet is one.
Is this not the most fucking Pee-wee's Playhouse shit you've ever seen? I mean, look at this.
never created one myself, but I had requests for one. So I built and sold one, and I put a lot of thought into what this should look like and how it should work.
I can tell. From it. My wishing machine slaps me with a rubber hand.
I don't personally like the looks of the way this turned out. The antenna is not a huge one. This is a small little stubby antenna in the back. You have the three tuning knobs.
Yeah, you tune this thing.
Jack.
You can't play this thing out of tune, okay?
Use this in conjunction with this.
Can you imagine?
Take this cord and plug it into...
I used to make shit like this when I was a kid. It was like broken phones
And get better connected.
Cables that my parents needed for things, you know?
Appropriately, plug this into the output so that whatever your intention is... That you're putting here, instead of just putting your picture...
So this is, of course, the concept is that there's an input... It just blasts your fucking ears. The concept, of course, being that there's an input for intention and an output for the result. So there's an in and an out, and it's got these two little alligator cables, and I would put those things straight on my nipples, but it's not about that. It's, I don't know what you hook it to. I don't know. You hook it to the helmet, and I guess you're the input. I don't totally get, are you the input or the output? You can put a photograph on one of those things. I would think you would put a photograph on the input. That's the intention. Something I'm hoping to get a lot of answers from Dr. Wish Machine. Dr. Wishmaker. I can't remember his name. His name's Kelsey. Hoping to get a lot of answers. So just stick around with me. He has like a prior engagement. He said, and that'll be over at 9. I asked him, you know, is it okay if I call you late? He said the later the better. He said he gets phone calls all night. Dr. Wishbone is gonna be helping me with some of my problems. I do sort of have an agenda with him.
How can you represent you as a witness for you here?
Represent you as a witness.
The helmet when you're with the machine. And you are plugging this into the output so that...
Oh, you are the output.
This enhances anything that you've done over here.
Yeah, okay.
You do, like with all my products, get a manual.
If I just Tesla coil the shit out of myself, if I can actually talk to Tesla.
Onyx helmet. Now, if you purchase one...
Yeah.
It's got a little bit of weight to it because there's some components inside of it. This is wired up. This is not just for looks.
Look at the little antenna.
You, of course, do not have a scratch or a stick plate like you do on here.
Uh-huh.
The texture of this portion of the helmet right here.
All right, let's take a look at his website, which is, of course, completely unreadable, fully illegible. If someone gets me Chopo's mailing address, I'll make him a wish machine like he's never fucking seen. Do it. Make me a wish machine. okay, so we'll try to read some of this just quickly. Imagine yourself getting into... First off, it says, welcome to my site, which I always appreciate. You should never go to someone's website if you haven't been welcomed as a guest therein. Imagine yourself getting into your car, ready to drive to work. You got up early, got dressed, went to the vehicle, opened the door, put the key in the ignition, but, the tank is completely dry. It has no energy, so it can't move. It doesn't matter how much you thought about the idea of going to work to do your job. All the arrangements, the preparation, and your willingness just weren't enough. A basic and essential element is missing. The power to transport you and your vehicle to your destiny. The same principle applies to visualization. All right, so who gives a shit? Here we go. Welcome. Law of attraction on steroids. We will be watching this video. We've got pictures of the wishing machine. It's only $589.50. We need to wet my tank for sure. Imagine having the capacity to build wish technology and having a GeoCities website. I have an old practice amp I could glue some crystals and feathers on. You could sell it for nearly $600, my friend. we've got some testimonials here. Absolutely speechless. It feels like the Twilight Zone. The machine is a portal into the supernatural. I wish I could tell you everything, but I must keep it to myself. I am learning so much about myself. Things that I never imagined. This is an amazing experience. I still don't understand it. God is going to richly bless you, Dr. Kelsey. I will never, ever forget you. So it appears that she purchased the Sibian Wish Machine. This is, of course, Christian girl Tracy. A mere 4 hours ago. She also wrote 4 hours ago, "Hi, Dr. Kelsey, I love you so much. Whatever your intention is." Okay? We don't even care. I love you. I love you, my man. The machine magnifies it by 1,000 times. I have never experienced anything like this in my life. It is a supernatural experience. This is so amazing. I'm speechless. Words cannot express how thankful I am to you. God led me to you so that you would create this magical wish machine for me. She got a very nice vibrator from this person. No one knows about my machine but my sister. But I keep my intentions to myself. No one knows but me. The machine sends my subconscious thoughts to the universe. The subconscious mind is the prover. Thanks so much. Screw it. I'm done. I had my wish machine for about 3 weeks. I was a bit frustrated because I did not understand why my original wish was not manifesting. Listen, you maybe just haven't tried the right equipment yet. If you're having difficulty achieving orgasm, you know, don't give up. You might need a machine that works at your frequency, if you will. My seasonal allergies were acting up, and I was just not in a good mood. I had errands to run, and nothing had been working right for the entire morning. Yeah, you know, if you got other stuff on your mind, it's probably not going to happen. I unplugged my machine. Well, you had one that plugged into the wall. That's a good start. I mean, at least you've got the horsepower necessary for most folk. I was at my wit's end. With a flourish, I took off the original wish. off of the machine. I said out loud, "Screw it! I'm done." I threw down a $20 bill on the input plate and left the house to run my errands. Well, it turned out that I ended up winning $420 in the Georgia Lottery online, plus an additional $120 hand that day. The first $100 came within an hour of my statement of, "Screw it, I'm done." The rest of the money manifested within 4 additional hours. I guess you can say that this is not bad for receiving over $500 within 5 hours. The wish-making machine not only paid for itself, but I made a profit. Okay? Got a picture of a cat. For a small fraction of what a wish-granting cat will cost you, go to the wish doctor and get your wishing machine and get your wishes fulfilled. Care to buy a living, breathing, wish-granting cat for $127,000? Okay? Do you see this? Do you see this? Forget wish-granting goldfish and genies in a bottle. You can now own your very own magical cat. And have all your wishes fulfilled for the modest price of 10 million rubles. $127,000. A Novosibirsk woman recently posted a bizarre ad on Russian classified ad platform Avito, asking people to pay a small fortune for her pet cat, a Scottish fold named Vincent the First, or Vinsik for short. The woman, known only as Elena, told Russian journalists that she discovered her cat's wish-granting powers by accident, but has since tested its effectiveness 3 times to impressive results. She now wants to share its magic with others, but is asking for a considerable fee as a reward for her kindness. Let's check this out. This is just nice. This just looks nice. Get what you want, of course. And then, of course, we scroll down to the bottom, and here's the good stuff. Sexuality and radionics. Teledildonics. It's necessary to point out that not everyone has an identical sexual configuration. Hormones and the life cycle can have a great influence in this respect. Suffering from illnesses or the use of various medications that act on the brain and other organic mechanisms as well. And you can't really read that whole section. Rock hard cocks. Yeah, I'll say whatever you want me to say. Here's this video, Live a Full Life with Radionics and Psionics. Here we go. Now let's just get to the part where he's showing the machine. He's got a really cool one in this video. Big fan. Look at that. again, I will be talking to this man in about 10 minutes. If all goes well, if he didn't stand me up. If he does, I'll do something. I'll do something naughty.
October, November, December. 4 months? Now, August, September, October, November. Well, counting August, December, 5 months. Here we are, the last week of December. And what I am doing,
just one day with a penis, yeah.
In the last just 5 months.
I feel you. I'd like the same.
Has been this right here. This
is love that.
To me, it's not new overall.
Let's really dig in.
Money became a big issue, not just for myself, but for a lot of people. Something had to change. I'm looking for ideas. I'm thinking.
He's very forward about the financial trouble he found himself in 2020 with the pandemic.
And I wasn't going to fight that because I am for health. I didn't want to be responsible for my greed imposing upon endangering lives. That's not where I
should. I wish to free the genie inside the wish machine.
So I kept my eyes open. I kept my mind open.
He seems like a little bit more sinister in this video.
And still, I got energy from Pink, and my energy from that is going on to you, and that energy is being transferred down the line.
You get a feel. You get a feel here. So let's check out the vampire machine, as this may come up in the conversation. My email is johnwednesday. I gotta go, but I'd love to make wish boxes. Email me with your requests, and I'll do my best. Hey, all the best, Puddin' Tame. So let's check out this vampire machine. Looks just like the wish machine. What does this do? This costs $777. The combo wishing and vampire machine. Let's check this out. Holy shit. Wow. Look at this. Cracking a safe. VampireMachine.com. There it is.
Okay, here's the latest. The only thing that's missing.
Bite me, baby.
This machine is the purple plate. I had to order another purple plate.
Oh, Putin did to make you the pyramid, yeah.
And the mail is slow right now. But this
that's
is
awesome.
A combination machine. And I want to kind of go over
the music
does, because this is not only a wishing machine.
It's about 7 minutes till I talk to this man.
Machine. And so I'm going to kind of explain what's going on here.
There's so much gorilla glue and excuse string.
So I'm doing this at my work desk today. So
a little bell
side, and you'll see a slot in the side of this machine.
Yeah.
Right here. In fact, I've got a tool.
Hey, Mary. God bless you. Make sure to watch the recording of this. I want you to hear the call if it happens.
All right. So, I've already explained.
This is a machine that sucks you.
How to use the wishing machine part. I do have the...
So this is a combo. This is a wishing machine.
It's right here.
Vampire machine combo.
Other videos that explain all that. I just don't have it sitting here right now. But this is the first video I'm doing that has the... Right here.
Look at that.
Yes.
A laser pointer.
Okay. And that's what makes this machine distinctly different. So... We're going to say that you need energy.
I need energy.
And it's called a vampire machine because you've probably heard of a psychic vampire.
Here we go.
Psychic vampire sucks energy. You know that you are associating with someone that is a psychic vampire because you feel depleted, you feel tired after being around them for a while. Your energy's gone because they have sapped it out of you. And so with a
rub energy like DBZ for Spirit Bomb
machine,
all beings
without being around the source of your energy, you can get energy from different sources. Now, some people may want to get energy from an individual.
You think that's ethical? What do you think his stance is going to be on, you know, sucking someone, their energy? What do you think? What do you think is going to be the attitude about that? I'd like to know. We'll ask him. Let's maybe do a little crowdsourcing here. Anybody got any questions for the Wish Doctor? For Dr. Wishbone? Dr. Wishbone McGone? Dr. Kelsey Grammis? Anybody? If you got a question you'd like answered, put it in the chat. We'll get there. A machine that sucks energy without consent does seem quite unethical, doesn't it? And Lord knows I'm headed straight to hell. But, you know, I know an unethical sucking machine when I see one. I tell you that much. The question, why are they? Yeah. Yeah, why? Why? We have another video by him, Radionics Explained. I am, you know, I'm just waiting to call him. I'll probably call him in about 3 minutes, but.
Human beings have known since ancient times about the importance of.
How cool is this?
Positive vibrations in the event of any contingency. In ancient Rome and even.
People ask him about Frasier. Can you give the energy back?
Many
I like that.
To generate.
Best way through a man's heart is through his stomach. What's the best way to a woman's heart?
Indeed. From expensive ceremonies that lasted days,
for sure.
Sacrifice of large animals.
Such can I use the machine oxygen. For evil?
In fact, the word heck,
make one of the fleshlight in it.
Today means catastrophe. Originally meant in Greek, the sacrifice of 100 oxen to create a favorable environment. Fortunately, today these practices have become obsolete. However, people still keep in mind that creating a good environment or having a positive vibration is essential to develop all kinds of capacities and actions.
How much of his lore is cribbed from what we do in the shadows? That what happens if you drop the box? Can it play my MP3s?
Development option that when one wears or uses a certain object or connects with a wishing radionics machine device, one will feel the magical powers of electrifying charges that encourage mental, emotional, and physical development. And ultimately,
are wishes unlimited?
Universal.
That's a great question.
Change outcomes in life.
How much wish do you get? Rich wants to know if you can use it to wish for a more powerful wishing machine. That's along the lines of the premise that I'm going to be trying to get into.
Gadgets, and we do it constantly with varying levels of awareness. Billions do this in the mode of prayer. Billions more use tools to
facilitate
the sending of intentions out, such as the...
probably only Ogvorus. It's like the Pono. It's like Neil Young's Pono.
So now, if you've been listening to my explanation of radionics and whatnot, you begin to realize just why people can have sudden headaches or euphoria, excitement. Wake up one day simply happy and another day for no apparent reason.
I'm going to wait like one more minute before I call him.
Not feeling good. No reason...
Though I am
certain burst of
impatience.
Many of the most popular songs in modern history were written that way. A sudden thought, and the words flow as if guided by some outside force, some invisible energy. Many of the most popular songs that you've listened to or sung have come from such instances.
What if I use my wishing machine to wish to undo all his wishes? Which machine wins? Again, that's sort of the premise that I have in mind. Let us once again navigate to the doctor's website. Wherein we may call him. What's the machine suck? Looks like it sucks quite a bit. All right. Here we go. Put in this number here. Wish me luck.
Thank you for calling Kelsey Grimm.
Yeah.
You may enter it at any time. For Dr. Kelsey Grimm, press 1. For Catherine Marie Administrative. Please wait while I try to connect you.
Nice.
Hello?
Hi, is this is Dr. Kelsey?
Yeah, one second here. Let me
okay.
Talk to you good. I gotta mute something here.
Oh, sorry.
If I can find my mute button. All right. How are you doing this evening?
I'm doing all right. I'm happy to finally be talking to you. Did my son call you earlier today?
Yes, he sure did. And you called just at the right time because I was involved in a thing until 9 o'clock, and it's 9:02, and I was just finishing it.
Oh, great! Yeah, I was pretty excited to call. I was at work, and I had my son call you just to make sure that you know we'd be able to connect.
Well, I am old school. I don't keep regular office hours.
Oh, wow. Okay.
My father was a little town preacher back in the days when preachers didn't keep banking hours, if you know what I'm saying.
I do.
And anyway, when you're serving, I think that you need to make yourself available. What I do with a wishing machine, I do it because of the profound effect it had on my life.
Oh, wow.
And still is having on my life. And so I felt like I needed to share that. I don't force it on anybody. And just like you, the people that buy these machines, they just find me.
Yeah.
I don't spend any money trying to get it out there, if you know what I'm saying.
I do. Yeah. I'm curious to hear what you use yours for. I mean, first and foremost, I'd like to buy one from you today. But I do want to hear a little bit more about it, and then I'll tell you sort of why I want one and what my current situation.
I understand. Well, this all evolved for me right in the middle of the pandemic.
Oh, wow.
2020.
Yeah.
I've got a very varied background, if you will.
Uh-huh. First so do of all, I.
Being the son, my PhD is in theology.
Uh-huh.
Okay. So spirituality was always a big thing. Now, having gone to the point of studying theology and so forth, I'm not going to be your typical preacher you're going to find in a pulpit at church.
Okay.
Okay. But the bottom line is that spiritual side of me adds to this mix. When I was a kid, do you know what a crystal radio is?
I do, yeah.
Yeah. So when I was a kid, I've been a nerd all my life. But the first radio I built was a crystal radio.
Sure.
And, you know, it's pretty fascinating to think that you can take a coil and some wires and pick up radio stations with no power.
Yeah, oh yeah.
Okay. That kind of ties into what Nikola Tesla was up to with a Tesla coil and sending electricity through the air.
Absolutely, yeah.
It all boils down to energy.
Uh-huh.
One term that I've used on my machines is I call it the law of attraction on steroids.
Okay, wow.
But billions of people depend on prayer.
Yes.
Okay, and they claim to have great results from prayer. And so anyway, we all, you know, the Catholics have the rosary, and a lot of people use prayer cloths. We all have different tools that we've used for whatever.
So yeah.
I'm not the first one that ever built a wishing machine, but
they're
very unique compared to others, okay?
Yes.
I've added a lot to it, and you're not going to find anywhere else, because I want it to be a very powerful tool, and
yeah.
It's been very successful. What happened with me during the pandemic is I do a lot of events. I do a lot of weddings.
Okay.
I don't think I have to tell you what happened with that during 2020.
Of course, of course.
And in the middle of that, my wife was on hospice at the time.
And, oh, no.
I could not, didn't have any help.
Yeah.
And my income went down. I didn't have any help. So anyway, the whole thing is that I don't know where this idea came from. It's called radionics, if you've heard of that.
I've started to look into it. Yeah.
So I had to go to Mississippi for a wedding over there, one of the few big weddings I had that year. And I designed and started to put together my own wishing machine, okay?
Uh-huh.
So I had this laid out on my desk, but I had not put it together. I just had some pieces playing around with it.
Yeah.
Within 3 days, my world changed dramatically.
Wow.
This is before I even got the machine put together.
Okay, you just had the components.
I just had the components. Literally had not even drilled a hole to attach dials or anything. Just was the pieces playing around with it to see how I wanted to lay it out.
Yeah.
So I put together a little website real quick, the same website you see now. And with it, and I didn't market. I don't do the SEO stuff and all that. I don't pay to have a Google listing, whatever.
Yeah.
Within a couple of days, I get an email from a guy in Minnesota said, I want to buy this machine. If I pay you for overnight shipping, we ship it to me overnight. And it's like, well, I haven't even built the machine yet.
Wow.
And when you're dealing with the internet, you're always skeptical, or at least I am.
Yeah.
So I made him call. I thought, okay, is this guy straight up?
Yeah.
And so I talked to him on the phone for over an hour.
Wow.
And he bought the first one he sold.
That's amazing.
Yeah, and it's just been that way. I've just threw off this whole deal. Well, right at 2 years now. I started in August, end of July, August in 2020.
Wow.
And it's been nonstop. It's just literally been nonstop. I have shipped these machines from Russia to Australia to Germany to South Korea. I jokingly but seriously say I live in Alabama, and Alabama is the only place I've not sold a machine.
Wow. I'm very happy to hear about your success and, you know, making it through some hard financial times, and that, you know, that's great. That makes me feel, I don't know if that's your intent, but it makes me feel a little bit more confident about buying a wishing machine.
I want you, and I want anybody that deals with this. Most people that buy them say, I was drawn to this.
Yeah.
I hear that a lot. I was drawn to this machine or whatever. And I like hearing that because I don't want to, and I don't promote, I don't do any of that because to me, this is almost a spiritual thing. We're dealing with energy.
Yeah.
We're dealing with the universe. We're all connected. And when you send out this and use this tool that we call a wishing machine, it can have powerful results. If you read some of the reviews that I've got on the website there, the stories these people have told me have been very profound.
Absolutely. I was reading some. Yeah, it seems like you've really touched people's lives with this.
Yeah, so I'm very, of course that makes me feel good, but it really makes me feel good if I'm helping somebody. And that's the bottom line.
That is the bottom line of it. Yeah. I agree. If it's helping, you know, then it's good.
Yeah, yeah. So clearly, if I wasn't in a capitalist society, I wouldn't worry about the money, but I'm in a capitalist society, so.
Here we are, you and me both.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, sorry, what was that?
No, I just said that's in brevity, that part of the story, you know.
Sure.
I had springboarded, and it did. My life turned around, and it not just from the selling of the machines, but getting help with my wife and a multitude of other things. Even the wedding thing picked up immediately after that.
I love that.
So it just, you know, and I tell people, I can't tell you, and here's the way it works. If you don't understand it, you've got to understand that you're not going to put an intention on this. You're not going to manifest something and then just automatically get up the next day and find $1,000 in your wallet.
Right.
That's not the way it works. The way it works, and I'll give you an example that somebody else gave me, is they bought a machine and they spent $300 on the machine several years ago. And they didn't really need anything, but they were just playing around with it. And they thought, well, what do I want to ask for? What do I want to manifest? And they thought, well, to get my $300 back. So within 3 days, they get a phone call saying, hey, are you available to do this speaking engagement? And they offered to pay them $300.
Wow.
So that's the way it works. One of the examples over in Atlanta, a lady bought the machines. She put a $20 bill on the input plate. That afternoon, she went out and bought some scratch-offs at the lottery and won $500-$600.
Wow.
So the whole point is, you still have to take action.
Okay,
you can't just lay back in bed and, you know, something, you know, it's not going to violate the laws of nature.
Okay.
I had one guy actually give me a bad review because it didn't grow his hair. He was bald and he wanted hair. I'm sorry, but that's not the way it works.
Sure.
I don't know your situation or what your expectations are, but I just want to make that clear with everybody that it is a powerful tool.
Yes.
It's not going to violate the laws of nature. You're not going to be able to fly, you know, sprout wings and whatnot, and it's not going to stop the aging process.
Okay.
You still have to go get Botox. I'm sorry.
Okay. Yeah. This is all very good to hear. This clarifies some things for me. Yeah. So my situation is actually that my next door neighbor bought one of your machines.
Okay.
Yeah. So that's how I heard about it. Not from him, but he bought one. And
right.
Yeah, it's sort of it's come to my attention though that maybe my neighbor isn't using it for like good things. Do you know what I mean? Like
right. You know, the sad part about it is anything can be used for nefarious reasons.
Right.
No matter what it is.
Yeah.
Christianity has been, I mean, look at Jonestown and so forth. So even Christianity has been used for bad things.
Right. Yeah. 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 I mean, I'm a Christian man myself. You know, I understand these things. But the thing is that my neighbor seems to be using it against me. We've always had kind of we've sort of been competitive, you know, with, you know, I got an F-150 truck, then he got one. You know, this kind of things that are just sort of silly. But it's been going on for, you know, 10, 15 years. And, you know, his wife has told me that he got one. And that he's been using it against me. And then I've started paying a little bit more attention and I've noticed some things. I'll notice him, you know, I have a pool in my backyard and I'll notice him, you know, and this alone is a violation of sorts, but he'll pop his head over the fence while I'm cleaning my pool and I'll see him take a picture. He's got a Polaroid camera and he takes a picture of me. And then the next, you know, not the next day, like you said, it doesn't happen right away, but, you know, the next week I'm cleaning my pool and I drop the, you know, the screen with the long handle. I drop that in the pool and then so it's like, okay, great. Now I got to go in to get it. I go in to get it. I'm reaching down in, you know, I'm like leaning over the side. I fall in. Right. My phone's in my pocket. I got to get a new phone now.
Yes.
it's happened, you know, I noticed, and so there's been a few things that have led to me having some accidents and some medical bills. And then, you know, I talked to his wife, and she's the one who told me that he's been using these pictures he takes of me. He puts them on the wishing machine, and so that's why he's taking the pictures, and he's sort of using this thing against me.
Yeah.
So, I mean, like you said, anything can be used for nefarious purposes. I'm not mad at you, but I am wondering, you know, if I were to get a wishing machine of my own, I don't want to target him. I don't want to do that, but I want to target his wishing machine with my wishing machine. And I could have his wife take a picture of it for me, and then I could put the picture of the wishing machine on my wishing machine, and then I just want it to stop working. That would be my wish.
I understand. So it sounds like that his wife is your ally on this.
Well, they're getting a divorce, actually, because of the relationship that has developed between me and his wife. You know, it's been... In so many words, we have become intimate, and they don't have that kind of relationship. So she's actually moved out, she has to go get some of her stuff in the next week. The divorce is still in like the filing phase. So when she goes to get her stuff, she could take a picture of his wishing machine, give me the picture of the wishing machine. I could put that on my wishing machine. And hopefully disable it.
Right. Well, yeah, and basically what you want to do too is use it just to put a protection around you and your property.
Right. Yeah. I'm not young anymore. Yeah. I can't keep tripping over shovels and rakes and, you know, it's taken a toll on me.
Yeah, well, and that's it, because you don't, you know, it's fine to just say, well, I need protection against this machine. I want to, you know, invalidate that machine over there. But, yeah, you want to just go ahead and protect your entire place and you.
Yeah, I wish him no harm. You know, I've done enough to this guy. And, you know, listen, I wish I had never started this relationship with his wife. I don't feel good about that. If I could wish for that to be undone, I would, but what's done is done.
Right. Well, I've had people use it for, I would say, somewhat similar circumstances.
You have?
To protect themselves.
Okay.
Or if someone, have you heard the term psychic vampire?
Of course.
Okay. So, somebody's draining your energy.
Yeah.
That's not so unlike what you're talking about, because the interference is there.
Yeah.
And I don't know what machine this individual bought from me. I could look it up if I had Oregon. Do you have a first name?
Oh, yeah. My name's Tobo.
No, I'm talking about your neighbor that bought the machine.
Oh, his name's Gordon.
Gordon. Most people that order, they might email me, but very few people like you do I ever have a conversation with.
Well, I appreciate you taking the time to talk to me, by the way. That's very kind of you.
Oh, I don't mind. Yeah, it's not that I won't talk to people. It's just if they don't contact me, I don't have their phone number or anything. I just have an address.
Okay.
So, yeah, so they never give me their phone number. And all I had was, so I sold to a rock star. Know it. Okay.
Yeah. Amazing.
That popped up because I'm looking for Oregon as I go through here.
Yeah.
I don't remember the name. Now, see, some people don't buy it. Some people buy it in a way that I don't have it in my log here. There's different ways they can buy it.
Okay. Yeah, that could be it. So could it be that, you know, if I just buy, I saw that you have a small version of the wish machine and a big version. So maybe if I buy a bigger one than my neighbor has, would I have more protection?
Well, absolutely. I mean, if you bought the most beefed up version I've got, of course, is the most expensive version I've got, but it is what I call the Trinity machine.
Okay.
Because it's got everything packed into it that you could ever desire. There's nothing you can't do with it. And it's really perfect for what you're attempting to do, because you probably never heard of a tepiphone.
I have never heard of a tepiphone.
So a tepiphone is part of this, and that means that actually you can set this in your living room, in your bedroom or whatever, and you can set it up with a picture of his machine and make that the target.
Okay.
And all you've got to do is aim that tepiphone toward his house.
Okay, cool. So it's like an antenna. Okay.
It's a light. It's a very strong, not quite a laser, but it's a very strong light.
Okay, great.
I wouldn't want to do it outside, because I wouldn't want to draw his attention to a light shining toward his place. It doesn't have to be. You could be in Oregon and use that tepiphone to do something with somebody in Georgia.
Wow.
It's not like, yeah, you don't have to. You just have to aim it in that direction.
Okay, that might be useful, because, you know, he's going to lose the house. So he'll be moving somewhere else. So I should probably get the tepiphone before he does.
Yeah, so that would come with the Trinity machine. Do you want me to send you a link?
I have your website up right now.
Yeah, I don't think I haven't got that updated. Most of what I'm selling comes off of Etsy.
Oh, okay.
So I will make sure you find it. That's just been the easiest way
for
me to deal with this over a period of time. I don't think I have that Trinity machine. Do I have it on my website?
I don't see it. I see the prayer board.
Yeah, I don't think I've got the wishing machine on there. I got the vampire machine, but
yeah.
Hold on, let me see. Let me look. Let me look. The easiest way is send you a link. I need to go through and update this machine. My wife just passed away in March.
I'm really sorry to hear that. I am really sorry that you went through that. That's very difficult.
But it's been, I was a caregiver for a long time, and
okay.
It was not unexpected, but I tell you what, even though you have grown to expect it, it still does not make it any easier
absolutely.
To deal with. Huge, huge void in my life.
I understand.
But anyway.
Yeah, no, I really, I'm sincerely, I'm sorry you had to go through that, but I'm happy that you're having success with this business, and that things are getting easier for you. I'm real happy to hear that.
Yeah, well, the positive side of all this for me is the fact that you guys give me a reason. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Does that make any sense?
It does. Yeah, you're helping people. If you know, I looked at the testimonials, and it seems like you're making people feel better, and I genuinely think that's worthwhile.
Yeah. Now, let me, I assume you got an email?
Yeah, you know, I think I've taken enough of your time. I'll get on your website. I'll order from you there. Or I'll email you, or I'll have my son do that.
Okay.
I think, I'm really happy I called you. There was a lot of really good information. And I'm a big Modest Mouse fan, so, I mean, if it's good enough for him, it's good enough for me.
Okay. Let's see. Yeah, I've got one here. Okay. You don't miss into this link?
Oh, no, it's okay. I got it. I'll be in touch for it. And
okay.
Yeah, thanks so much for talking to me, Kelsey. I really appreciate it.
No problem. And I really wish you the best of what's going on over there, regardless of how you choose to proceed on it. I hope everybody comes out in a very positive way.
Hey, same to you. I wish you the best. I hope you have a good night, and a good rest of the month.
Thank you, sir.
All righty. I'll talk to you later, Kelsey.